Hi sisters, James Charles here and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Hi sisters, hi sisters, hi sisters, hi sisters, hi sisters.
Hey yo, what's poppin'? Now I'm about to talk about James Charles cause this is getting out of hand. Now this is not the first time that James Charles has been caught up in something like this. It's been plenty of times, too many times actually. And I just want to read a tweet from my boy Mudahar. And here it is. James Charles is incredibly irresponsible creator using his platform and constantly involving himself with minors. Tons of legal cock out there, and yet this man child keeps fucking up. Shit's inexcusable.
Damn, boy, that took too many times to do.
Now, the first big drama I seen James Charles in was probably with the Tati situation, and it backfired and hit Tati. And then everything cooled down, and then it started to get back up. When a fan came out to expose James Charles when he was 14, James was saying some foul stuff in the text messages because he lied and said that he was 18, and everybody thought Shane Dawson and Jeffree Star was correct. Now, this boy has came out and said that he was 14 at the time. He even told James on Snapchat and FaceTime that he was 14, and James still continued. And here is a video now of him explaining that.
Anybody that has seen the James Charles video and has commented on that post, on that video, talking about where's the facts, where's the receipt saying that you were 14, I don't have the receipts. I told him on FaceTime, I told him on Snapchat. I have like a video of us being on FaceTime. Okay, I am 14 years old. I have 330,000 followers on TikTok. I'm not trying to be arrogant. My age is on the internet. Okay, it says 15. It's a 1 year difference. I'm still a minor. I'm still underage. My age is on the internet. Okay, if he really wanted to look that deep into it, he could have looked up my age. I told him my age. He knew my age. So to everybody saying, where's the receipts? I don't have the receipts. I have the receipts of him wanting to fly me out, though. I have the receipts of all of that, okay? He was trying to flip it on me saying that I said I was 18 years old. I didn't say I was 18 years old, okay? He talked about me on Logan Paul's podcast and texted him asking if there was shade being thrown at me. You know what? He said no. He was talking about some Romanian boy, okay? First of all, it's crazy how that Romanian boy said everything I was saying to him, making all those excuses. I was uncomfortable. I didn't want to come see you alone. I had my homeboy. I asked my homeboy if he would come with me because I didn't want to be with you alone because you sent me nudes. You sent me nudes, and every time you sent me nudes, I left you unopened. I left you on open, and you know what? You would get mad, or you would snap back. You would continue snapping me, okay? I was scared. I didn't know what to do, all right? I had mixed emotions. I didn't know what to do.
And this was just the first dude that came out to expose James Charles. Now, it looks like another dude has came out and said James Charles has did the same thing to him, but when he was 16. And I think he still is 16, but that doesn't matter because he's still a minor. And the dude said that James Charles knew his age, but continued to still talk to him. And it doesn't make no sense, James. You gotta do better.
I will be talking about grooming and James Charles. So if you get triggered by any of those, keep scrolling. But if not, watch this video, please. So last Wednesday on the 17th, James Charles snapped me on Snapchat. He added me back because I had snapped him a while ago, just like a fan to influencer conversation. I was excited because he's my biggest influencer-wise, and I've always looked up to him, so I was excited to get his message back. I don't have a lot of time, so I'm gonna post proof of it right now. This is the notification that I got when he Snapchatted me first. And just for further proof, he deleted the chat. I don't know what he deleted, but that's me opening his Snapchat. I went into the bathroom, and I guess he saw the bathroom light, so he started making the conversation very sexual, and it made me really uncomfortable. And I'll post some of the stuff that he sent me now. You can't see it because it's blurry because I took it on my iPad because I didn't want him to see that I screenshotted it, but I'll post it right now. He proceeded to send me explicit pictures of his body. More in part two. So this is part two of the James Charles story. So after sending me that first picture of his body, explicitly, he sent me multiple after that, and I'll post them now. I was getting really uncomfortable, so I told him my age. I told him I'm 16. Meanwhile, he's 21. He's a grown man. And then he proceeds to say, oh, but I didn't even get to see the, yeah, meaning my body. And after telling him, like, no, like, I'm not gonna send it to you, he kept on asking for pictures and videos of body hair and me flexing and stuff. He proceeded to ask to FaceTime me, which I then said no to, and then I asked why. And this is what he said. It's sad to say that I can't even look up my biggest influence the same again. I've heard multiple stories about him doing this to people, but you never believe it until it happens to you. So now I'm a big believer of what James Charles does to other people, and it sucks because he has so much going for him and he does this to himself.
That is so horrible, man. That is horrible. I feel bad for everybody that has been put in these situations and didn't know what to do, because maybe we haven't been taught that, oh, well, if this happens to you, you do this. Now, the boy is 16, and he told James Charles that he was 16, and James still asked for pictures and stuff. That's weirdo behavior. Yep. That's weirdo stuff. Now, the next victim I'm about to show you is the dude that I saw on TikTok when I was just scrolling and I seen this video on my For You page. Now, let me roll the clip. Could have seen that coming. James Charles exposed for allegedly messaging a 15-year-old. When James noticed that the boy shared one of their messages on his story, James snaps, accuses the boy of lying about his age, then blocks him. Boy alleges he never lied about his age. See? You see what I'm talking about? James Charles is down bad. This is so irresponsible, and James Charles just keeps getting caught over and over and over again. Shout out to Deaf Noodles for posting these videos, and shout out to Cody Rent for this post I'm about to show you right now. James Charles admitted to dating high schoolers. Excuse me, what?
Talk to guys that live in different states and stuff, and I'm like, hey, like, why don't you come visit? And like, well, I can't afford a plane ticket. Yep. And it's like, okay, well, I can. So like, get on the plane. And like, well, I just don't really feel comfortable with that. But like, I love you and I really want to be together. And I'm like, well, we can't be together because you can't afford a plane ticket. You're probably still in either high school or college, like a senior in high school or in college.
Right.
So like, either you accept the flight and realize that like this is what I'm bringing to the relationship so we can spend time together if you actually care about me, or we literally never meet because you can't afford it.
That's right.
Now, I see plenty things wrong with this video. That James Charles just said that if you don't accept the flight, I never want to meet you again. Now, remember, people are busy and we have things to do and we have our own life. I don't have to hop on a plane for nothing, for nobody. If I want to stay home and you know, chill by myself, I'ma do that. And then he said that you're probably in high school or college. Explain that, James. Why would you go for somebody that's in high school? Why not in college? That's just weird to me. Even though a senior in high school can be 17 to 18, 19, but isn't James like 22? Now, another video I'm about to show you is something very weird, like top tier weird. Like, I don't even believe James Charles can do this type weird. But Deaf Noodles posted on Twitter saying, who could have seen this coming? James Charles' hometown friend exposes James for catfishing his high school soccer team for their nudes. Another one of James' high school friends also exposed him for this years ago. And here's the video attached with that.
Is it just me, or does like everybody from the 518 just know that James Charles catfished his whole high school soccer team for all their nudes, and like nobody ever says anything? Like, I've never seen it really go like publicly or anything, but I've talked to so many people in the 518 about like James Charles, and they're like, oh my god, you know the catfish situation? Like, we all know it, but all the people from his hometown just don't say anything. Like, what?
Now, y'all heard what she said, and this is actually true because people are actually confirming this. And on Twitter, they're actually confirming this. And the fact that he really, really did this, he should be in prison. He should really be in prison. He should be locked up right now. Because isn't catfishing against the law? I'm going to say yes, it is. Because look at this. And James, you just broke that rule. Okay, you're catfishing people for nudes, man? That's disgusting. James Charles is a pedophile. James Charles is a child groomer. James Charles is a child predator. James Charles is a criminal. James Charles must lose all sponsors. James Charles is a deviant. James Charles deserves jail time. And I absolutely agree. This man shouldn't be on YouTube talking to his fans, underage fans, actually. It's not good for him to still be on this YouTube platform. He should definitely be suspended. What the fuck does he ever learn? He sounds like such a fucking creep. Hitting on minors, asking for nudes, being rude. This is very a lengthy video, and I think I said mostly everything I wanted to say. I would say more, but I feel like if I keep going, I would get demonetized. Oh, cuz boys, there are many things I want to say right now. If you made it to the end, I just want to say thank you very much for watching this long video that I made in my entire life. And my name is Benji Commentary, and you should subscribe, like the video, and turn on post notifications for more videos like this in the future. And I'm out. peace. Stay safe out there and be careful with your surroundings. Now, peace for
real. Oh my God, now she's sounding like